In this video, we're going to look at how we can use the Maps app to help us get from one place to another, basically get directions. In another video, I talked about how we can use a Maps app to look up information, one of my favorite ways to look up information. You may want to check out that video to see how we can create guides and save different locations and look up information on businesses. In this video, we're going to look at how we can get directions, add stops, and even choose how we want to travel and share our ETA with people who are waiting for us. Now, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can use the Maps app for directions on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. First thing we need to do is we need to open up the Maps app. I tap on it. And what we're going to look at first is how we can mark our location. Let's say you're in an area and you're not familiar with it. You go walk away from your car, and now you want to walk back to the car. How can you do that? Well, if we swipe up, this is actually a card here. We just swipe up, and when we go to the very bottom, you're going to see Mark My Location. When I tap on this, what it's going to do is it's going to mark your location on the iPhone, and then what you're able to do is get directions back to that location at a later time. So I just tap on it. It marks my location. And now if I were to walk away, I lose track of where the car is. All I need to do is just go to, I swipe up, I go to my marked location. When I tap on that, and then I tap on directions, the little blue button there, what it's going to do is it's going to give me directions back to my car. So that's the first thing. If you're in an unfamiliar area and you walk away and you need to get directions back to the beginning, this is one way of doing it. Just mark your location and then you can get directions back to your location. We also have another option there. It doesn't really have anything to do with directions, but I'll show you. You're also able to share your location with someone. When you tap on that, what you're able to do is send your location to someone via messages. And then they're going to know where you are. Now, this is not like Find My. With Find My, someone can look up your information all the time. All this is just a snapshot. So they're not going to be able to track you or anything like that. But you can easily send your location just by doing that. All right, now let's look at how we can create routes. Maybe I want to go from one place to another. Or let's say I wanted to go down to Atlanta. I want to drive down to Atlanta. How do I do that? Well, basically, all I have to do is just go in here and search. I search for where I want to go. So I'm going to type in here Atlanta. And you're going to see directions. I don't have to tap on directions. In some cases, it might not have it there. So I could just tap on Atlanta here. And when I do, to get directions, what I do is I just tap on this here. And then that will give me directions over to Atlanta from my current location. But we do have a few options in there. So I'm going to tap on it. And then from here, what I'm able to do is select how I want to get down there. Do I want to drive down there? Do I want to walk down there? I'm certainly not going to walk, but it does give me that option. So if it's a shorter route, you could say you're just going to walk over there. You can also select public transportation, and it'll show you how to get there using public transportation, as well as bicycle and ride sharing. So from here, you choose how you want to get to where you're going. I'm going to keep it with the car, so I keep it selected on the blue one here. And now, if I swipe up, I can see I have three different routes here. So one of them is going to be 11 hours, 2 minutes. Another one's going to be 11 hours, 26 minutes. And the other one's going to be 12 hours and 23 minutes. So from here, I need to decide which one I want to use. Well, what I would like to do is see what those routes are. Well, you can easily do that. You can actually see what those routes are there. So if you want to take a specific highway, you could do that. Or if it's public transportation, you could select which public transportation you want to use. So now, once you decide which one you want to go with, we're just going to stick with this one here. All I do is just tap on go, and it'll give me directions. Now, let's say I wanted to make sure that I stop in Nashville. I'm not sure which one of these routes go through Nashville. Well, what I can do is I can add a stop. All I do is just tap on add stop. I type in here Nashville. And then I tap on Nashville, Tennessee. I could actually put in a specific location. Maybe if I knew what hotel I was going to stay at, I could put that in there. Next thing that I need to do is I need to make sure that it's in the right order. You're going to see that this is kind of backwards. I'm going to Atlanta and then Nashville. That's not actually the way that I'm going. I'm going to Nashville first. So what I do is I take this and drag it up. And when I do, now I have the proper order. So it's rerouting me here, and it's going to give me my directions. Now, before we tap on go, that's basically what we do is we tap on go, and it'll give me directions there. But before we tap on go, we have a couple more options. First thing I can do is I can set what I want to avoid. Do I want to avoid tolls, as an example? So I tap on that, and I can avoid tolls or highways. So let's just go ahead and avoid tolls. Tap on it, and now it's going to reroute me around any toll roads. Next thing that I'd like to do is I would like to leave at 8 in the morning. Maybe it'll have a different route because of traffic. Traffic is always heavy in the morning. Well, if we look here, you're going to see that I have now. This is when I am going to leave. Well, I'm not leaving right now. I'm leaving at 8 in the morning. So let's see what the route is when I leave at 8 in the morning. So I tap on that, and then make sure it says leave at. We're going to go with tomorrow at 8 a.m. I tap on apply, and now what it's going to do is it's going to look at forecasted traffic, and it might come up with a different route based on the traffic. Let's reverse this. Maybe I'm going there for an event, and I need to be there by 5 o'clock on Saturday. The event is Saturday evening. So when would I have to leave if I wanted to be there by 5 o'clock? Well, we can do that as well. Again, we go back down to the bottom here where it says leave Friday. This time what we do is we go arrive by. And when I tap on arrive by, I can set when I want to arrive. So I'm going to go Saturday. And this time we're going to go 5 p.m. And now when I tap on apply, what it's going to do is it's going to tell me when I should leave. So basically, if I want to get there by 5 o'clock, what I need to do is I need to leave at 5:39 a.m. on Saturday morning. Based on traffic, I'll get there by 5 o'clock. So if you're using this for directions and you're not leaving right away, make sure that you tap on now and then you can set when you are going to arrive or you can set when you're going to leave, because then it'll take the traffic or it'll guess at what traffic is going to be there based on trends, and it might reroute you in a different direction. You'll have a more accurate time of how long it's going to take you to get where you're going. Now, since I'm not leaving now, what I'm able to do is view the steps. When I tap on this, I can see the different steps that I'm going to be taking on that route. To go back, all we have to do is just tap on the little carrot here. I go over here to end route, and what it'll do is it'll end that route. I want to go again. I can go and tap on resume. And now it's routing me. It's getting the directions. And if I wanted to leave right now, all I would have to do is just tap on go and I could leave right now. Another thing that we can do is we can set the map, of course. Right now this is used for driving, but when I tap on the little icon, the car icon, what I'm able to do is set if I want to explore or view transit maps as well as satellite maps. So I can choose from any one of these four maps. By default, it goes over to driving. That's actually my favorite map to use. Now, when you are on your way somewhere, what you may want to do is share the ETA. Let's say that I know somebody over in Atlanta and I would like to share my ETA with them. How can you do that? Well, basically what you do is you just start the route. So I'm just going to go with go here. And when I do,
starting
it's going
to
give
Atlanta,
me directions on how to get there. And then down at the bottom
head
here, you're going to see
West
share
28th
ETA.
Street, then turn right
when I
onto
tap
Michigan
on
Avenue.
That, I would type in who I want to share my ETA with. And then they're going to get updates on where I am at and my ETA, my estimated time of arrival. So if I hit traffic, they're going to know that I might be there a little bit late. Or maybe traffic is really good. They might know that, or they will get an alert saying that I might be there a little bit early. So they're going to see my ETA or get an estimate of when I'm going to arrive. To end the route, you just tap on the little carrot there. And then from here, we tap on end route. Or what you can do is you can go and add a stop. share the ETA, or if there's an incident, you can report an incident. We're going to go with end route. I'm actually not going to go to Atlanta right now, so I just end the route, and now that route is ended. Now, one thing I want to mention here, if you watch my other video on looking up information using the Maps app, you know that we have a library. And when we go into the library here, you're going to see that we have routes. I have four routes there. Well, these routes are actually for hiking. You cannot save a current route into the library, at least not that I know of. I haven't found a way to do that. We can't save a road trip route, I guess you could say. You can save hiking routes, but you can't save a road trip route. All right, let's take a look at the settings. We can set our preferred type of travel. We can set our directions. To do that, what we need to do is we just need to go to our settings app. So I swipe up, and then we go over here to settings. And now what I do is I just swipe up, and we go over here to apps. I tap on apps, and now I need to go to maps. So I'm just going to tap on the M here, and when I do, I go over here to maps. Gives me a little shortcut. Tap on it, and here are my settings for the Maps app. So what am I looking at here? Well, basically what I can do is I can set my preferred type of travel. I typically will use it for driving, but if you live in a big city, maybe you want to use it biking or walking instead of driving. My nephew lives in Chicago. He doesn't have a car. He'd probably use walking. So you can set your preferred type of travel. So then when you get directions, what it'll do is it'll select that one by default. In my case here, it selected the car by default. In my nephew's case, what it would do is it would select walking by default. We can also set the settings for each preferred type of travel. So let's say that I would like to avoid tolls when I drive. I tap on driving, and I can tell it to avoid tolls automatically. I could always override it, but by default, it's going to avoid tolls. And then, if I go over here to cycling, I can set it to avoid the hills. So I just tap on the slider there, and now it'll avoid the hills. Probably won't do a good job in San Francisco or Seattle, but in Holland here, make it pretty easy to do. We don't have a lot of hills here. And then the last thing here is show parked location. When I turn that on and your car is connected to your iPhone, it could be via Bluetooth, it could be via CarPlay. When it is connected to the car and you walk away, it disconnects from the car, right? Well, when it disconnects from the car, when this is turned on, what it'll do is it'll automatically save your location. So then you no longer need to, I'm going to go back over to the Maps app, you no longer need to mark your location if you're using your car. If you walk away from your car, it'll mark it automatically. It'll show you where your parked car is. So then all you'd have to do is just go to the top here and you'd see your parked car here. And then you can get directions to that car. That only works when your iPhone is connected via Bluetooth or via CarPlay over to your car. But you want to make sure that that is turned on if it is connected to your car. It makes it really easy to save the location. It does it automatically. So that is how we use the Maps app for directions on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, basically, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. And you'll have access to my classes and webinars. Not only that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I am not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.